1000 rounds is done over, people of Serbia. Congratulations, the Zastava Zipap is in one piece. That's a good news. I'll tell you right away, I did clean the bore of the rifle already because I had to run a bore scope, and I clean a bolt and the trunnion to take the better pictures. So I know at least these parts are looking good, but we'll get into this in a second. Actually, Zastava did slightly more than the 5,000 rounds. The reason for this was because, as you know, we were running the can, and in some scenes I couldn't use the outstanding OSS suppressor. This is the reason for this was because when we were throwing to the mat or doing the Centornado test, that's not really a smart idea. So I had to add some extra rounds and run, because I wanted to have the 5,000 rounds on that can as well, and the OSS suppressor jellies perfectly with this Zastava rifle. That Helix QD can is outstanding. That's the fantastic combo. But enough with the bullshit talk, let's go to the details. So I'll tell you after the 5,000 rounds, but before cleaning, I did took that rifle to the extended range because I wanted to see how is the accuracy on it still looking like. And let me tell you, with the setup as we have here, this is our annihilator combo, and again the suppressor and the Wolf HP hollow points, we did score beautiful hits at the 400 rounds, which accumulated to the 1.5 MOA. Can you hit the 500 rounds with it? 500 yards targets with it? As you can see on the footage, yes you can. So the Zastava still delivers. Is it a 1.5 MOA rifle? No, it's probably more like a 2 MOA rifle. But still, it's holding the accuracy what you would expect from the, not the brand new, but the, like 2019 made rifle. It is within the 2 MOA and it delivers. I guess the manufacturers of the AKs are trying to really stay below the 3 MOA today, which is a standard for that type of the rifles, and this is the classic example. So yes, the Zastava still holds a decent accuracy, and as I said, the 1.5 MOA at 400 yards, I'll take that all day long from the rifle like this with the ammo. So that being said, as you can see from the footage, from the pictures, from the bore actually is looking very nice. There was, I think, on one segment of the crown, I have seen a little bit deformation, not deformation, but like maybe a missing piece on the rifling, but that's pretty much it. The gas port, the rifling, and right past the chamber, the throat, is everything's looking very good for that type of the mileage. And I think that's a good signal. Surprisingly, there was no rust inside of the barrel, so that's the good news. Also, from the outside inspection, I will tell you that this is the first Zastava which completed the test and review, and it's not damaged. There's no cracks on the receiver. All the rivets are looking good, and it survived as it should after the 5,000 rounds test. As you can see, the finish is gone in some parts of the receiver, and over the barrel, and other components of the rifle, but this adds the tones of the character. Whoever is going to win this rifle on the giveaway, and a big thank you to the friends from the Atlantic Firearms for making it possible. They were working with us, and they basically, you gotta thank them too for helping. And basically this rifle will go to one of you guys. We'll make the special episode, and we'll make a drawing. The guys from the Atlantic Firearms will choose the winner. I'll put the original furniture back too, so you guys going to have it in original setup. But rifle looks with the tones of character, whoever's going to win it is going to have a really nice piece of the hardware, and that makes me happy. But enough with the bullshit talk. Again, let me take off the our outstanding annihilator combo down. And Drum Magazine, speaking about the malfunctions, there was a one malfunction when I was running the Drum Magazine, but it was the fault of the Drum Magazine. Guys, those drums magazines are tons of fun, but they are not really that reliable. So keep that in mind when running and shooting those magazines, okay, from those magazines. Also, we did talk in the previous episode about the issues with retainer pin, not the retainer pin, but the fire control group and the pins for the fire control group and that paperclip. I honestly hope so that the Zastava will take this to their heart and they will start putting the retainer plates instead of paperclip with those rifles. So that's something what I'm really hoping that they will do. Also, as far as the safety goes, I hope they will trim down the safety and make it semi-auto. There's no point to have the full auto safety on it. All right, the recoil spring looks absolutely perfect. No damages, no nothing, no issues with that. Let me pull out the bolt carrier and the bolt. I will start with the bolt carrier. As you guys remember, the main reason why the Zastava is using original Serbian fire control group was because they said this will help to prevent the damage to the rear end of the bolt carrier. And there is some slight deformation, as you can see on the pictures, but after 5,000 rounds, this is looking very, very good. And I think I see the Zastava's point. So I think they you know, this is the living proof that they are up to something. So not much on that rear end. The channel looks fantastic too. I clean only those parts. Whoever's going to win it, you have to clean the rest. Okay. Bolt, guys. When I'm looking at the bolt, at the locking locks, at the extractor clutch, the firing pin, it is absolutely amazing. If someone would show me this, I wouldn't believe it that this part went through the 5,000 rounds. But this is the testament to, like, if you have a good parts, this is what you want to have the parts looking like. And everything here is looking great, just simply great. So I'll put the bolt away. Let me have a look inside the trunnion. There is some slight damage. We talked about it at the beginning of the series when the front trunnion on the right side, the locking shoulder is starting and there's that jump off from the rail. So you can see some mark on it. Then the right side of the trunnion, there is some wear, but this is still within the spec. Of course, we'll see how this is going to end up when we'll run the gauge on it. But I don't believe that we'll have any problems on it. But stay tuned, of course, for the head spacing test. And the left side of the trunnion is looking normal too. Inside the chamber, everything is okay. I did talk about the fire control group. I did talk about what had to be done on that plate when the hook is latching to. Something to keep in mind too. The Zastava guys, you can do that at the factory level. So the users don't have to do it. And from the bottom of the trunnion, everything here is looking good. Trigger guard and the magazine latch perfectly fine, guys. All right, I will remove right now the gas tube and we'll have a look at how everything up front is looking like. I have to use my retard strength to pull the lever. There you go. And here's the pirate for you guys. R for the Pirates Union. Everything inside the gas tube is looking fine and no rust on this part. Right, barrel, there is the surface rust. You cannot deny that, guys. There's that layer of the rust on the barrel here and going forward. So that's something what we had after the swamp. And you have to remember to keep those rifles clean. Keep them clean and take care of it. Inside the gas block, we're looking good. There is nothing there. And the pins on the front post on the gas block are looking good. I do not see any deformations. Of course, there is the rust on the cleaning rod. That's something what I talked about in the previous episode as well. So again, you have to take care of the rifle. You have to clean it, no brainer. This is the 5,000 rounds test. The maintenance on the rifle is minimal, guys. So it is what it is. I'm just showing you what is happening, right? And at the rear side leaf, let me look underneath. Everything here is looking good. So the components are looking good. I forgot to talk about the piston head. There is some slight wear of marks, maybe on the piston head, or maybe I'm just seeing the things. It's looking good, slight wobbling, but everything here is looking within the spec. Don't go anywhere, we still have to run the final head spacing test. Belgrade Express setup, the no-go gauge in place. My dog is going crazy. That squeaky noise, that's from ball that puppy is playing. Ula, could you show it to them? What that crazy dog is doing? Only at AKOU videos, guys. The shit like this is happening. But anyhow, the Belgrade Express setup, let's go. And look at that. Now I can see the champagne being open in Zastava USA headquarters. One more time, nothing. And just to make sure, this is for the people, good people of Serbia. Let's go. Everything is good. So that means, guys, that means that the Zastava USA Z-Pop completed the 5,000 rounds of series and is still good to go. No physical damage to any of the components. Rifle is looking very good. Congratulations to the OSS suppressors. Fantastic performance on your can. This setup really jellies great. As you can see, the accuracy is outstanding as well. And we will have one more final episode about the Zastava Z-Pop. That will be a giveaway. Do not miss that episode. Big thanks to the folks from the Atlantic Firearms. Big thanks to the folks from the CS Spec for providing those floor plates for us. Everyone, thank you for watching. Thanks for being with us. Thanks for supporting AK Operators Union.